socialites and celebutants. You know who it is? This is your boy Zim Van Adams, coming to you live from here in West Hollywood, California. And I want to pose the question for you all today. The question is, do you know what it means to be in love with yourself? Have you ever taken the time to truly fall in love with yourself? That's the question. And people ask me, what does it mean to be in love with yourself? I don't know if I'm in love with myself, and I'm gonna tell you. For me, I know that the journey began years ago, more so around 2005, when I first got out of my four-year relationship. I began to learn myself again. I began to figure out what it was that ultimately made me feel good about myself and made me happy when he was not there. Do you know what I mean? And what I began to do was sort of first, I didn't destroy all of the physical memories of my relationship, and that's something we all tend to do when we're trying to fall out of love with our exes and fall in love with ourselves. We tend to destroy pictures, and we want to destroy cards and memories, and that's the worst thing to do, because in a sense what you're doing is you're tearing a large part of yourself away, which has contributed to the individual you've become. So you don't want to sort of fall into the regime of destroying pictures and cards and photos. You don't want to get rid of those memories, because that's going to help you fall out of love with him and the relationship and fall in love with yourself, because you get to see how you grew and how you changed and how you matured during that period of time. You have to accept the fact that you aren't perfect and that you make mistakes, and you have to be willing and able to work on changing those things. For me, you know, I did therapy. I went to therapy to deal with a lot of my emotions and a lot of my pain. Because once you're able to accept the things about yourself that aren't perfect, and you're able to acknowledge them and say, I'm going to work on those things, then that leaves room for you to actually grow and build. So for me, that's what I did. I accepted my weaknesses, and I worked on them. That was a part of the process of me falling in love with. Too often, I hear people say to me, or send me messages saying, I just want to find somebody so I can be happy. I just want to find somebody so I can be happy. Or, I wish I had a boyfriend so I could be happy. I don't sometimes think people understand and realize the fact that in life, you cannot, by any means, have a child to make yourself happy, buy a dog or a cat to make yourself happy, or get into a relationship expecting another individual to make you happy. If you aren't content with your job, the way you look, the people you spend time with, the things you have, the amount of money you make, the relationship you have with your family, the school you go to, your grades, if you aren't happy about the elements that create your life, you can't expect another individual to enter your world and create that happiness for you. That is an element that you have to create for yourself. Then and only then do you truly stand in a position to accept someone in your life. Because once you've accepted all of your weaknesses, all of your strengths, all of your shortcomings, and you have worked on and are working on fixing the things you don't like, that's when you can accept someone else to come into your space who is going to critique you, who on certain levels are going to judge you. A relationship is not in existence to make us happy. Two happy individuals who come together make the most healthy relationship. Fall in love with who you are, and then you won't need to seek that level of guidance or that level of acceptance from other people. You would, on a typical Friday or Saturday night, a lot of people, you know, get dressed up, go out to clubs, dance, party, hang out with their friends. Part of falling in love with yourself is finding a peace within who you are when no one else is around. Being able to be comfortable in your own space, in your own body, knowing that company is not coming over to spend the night, that friends aren't coming over to drink, that you aren't going out. You know, for me, especially when I was in Baltimore, there was a spot called China Walk in Newtown, Owings Mills, where I lived. And they had the best shrimp and broccoli. And I love shrimp and broccoli. And I would go oftentimes on Saturday nights, Friday nights, Sundays, and I would get a pint of shrimp and broccoli. And I would go to the liquor store that was right around the corner, and I would get myself a nice bottle of Chardonnay, and I would go rent a couple of movies from Blockbuster Video, and I would go home and have a date with myself. You know, I would eat shrimp and broccoli, and I would drink my Chardonnay and get very relaxed, and I would turn off my phones, I would, you know, stay off the computer, and I would just spend that time with myself to really reflect upon what I wanted out of life, reflect upon the stages that I had come into, and then I would wake up the next day and feel good about myself and, you know, treat yourself to things. I'm not saying, of course, to go on shopping sprees and splurge, because that's very unhealthy, but when you see something nice that usually someone else will buy for you, whether it be a boyfriend or a date or a girlfriend or what have you, buy it for yourself. And it doesn't have to be for a specific occasion. If you like it, you want it, it's in your budget, buy it, treat yourself. You know, it feels good sometimes just to put on something new to make yourself feel good about yourself. And that's okay. That's okay. Treat yourself. Treat yourself. Date yourself. You know, that helps you to fall in love with yourself. Falling in love with yourself has nothing to do with arrogance. It has nothing to do with conceit. It's about accepting who you are as an individual without needing the sort of accolades from other individuals, compliments from other individuals, or acceptance from other individuals. It's about accepting yourself, knowing that you are capable of being at peace in your own environment. Like, it kills me that there's so many individuals who can't live by themselves. They have to have a roommate. They can't go to the movies in a theater, or go to, even to a matinee and watch a movie they really want to see by themselves, or they won't go somewhere because no one wants to go with them. And that's crazy to me. Or you see people when they're out and they're walking, they're always on their sidekicks, or always on their Blackberries, and always talking. Like, they can't walk through a mall or walk down the street without having some sort of gadget or something going on. That displays a lack of self-esteem and confidence. You can tell in the way people walk. You know, you have to know that you are the ish, that you have what it takes to survive in this world, and you don't need anyone else to help you stand in your own truth. Stand in your own truth. Love who you are, because if you don't love who you are, no one else is going to. Like a runner.